this, take bayah on my hand that Yazid is your caliph. Then I will listen to you. Now, what should Imam Hussain do at that time? Whether he take bayah or not? Now, this was the test of Iman. That he didn't take bayah 3 years ago. Now, he left Medina, but he didn't compromise on his principles. He left Makkah, he didn't compromise on his principles. And now, at this time, again he said, my stance is the same. If you want to fight with me, then it's okay, but I will not accept Yazid as caliph in your hand. Then they announced that now we have to kill them. Then Hazrat Imam Hussain radiallahu ta'ala anhu, 72 people were with him from his family, and some other people, they joined him, even some people from Yazid army, they also joined Imam Hussain when they listened his speech. And 300 almost people, they were with him. And then at the night of 9th of Muharram, he gathered all people and he told them that Yazid only wants me, dead or alive. You people, you may leave me. If you want to go to your homes, you can go. And then he turned off all the lights. That maybe you will feel a kind of embarrassment that you are leaving me alone. You may say 10 minutes your time, again the lights were on, all the people were there. No one left him over there. And then on the 10th of Muharram, there was fight between Yazid's army and their people. All the people, they were martyred. Cousins of Imam Hussain, brothers, his son, his nephew, even the small one, baby, Hazrat Ali Asghar radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And because their water was stopped before few days and they were very thirsty, Imam Hussain brought Hazrat Ali Asghar radiallahu ta'ala in front of people that this baby is dying due to thirst. Can you provide water for him? Meanwhile, an arrow came and it was inside the neck of Hazrat Ali Asghar. Then Imam Hussain radiallahu ta'ala, he took the blood and he threw like this. It was a kind of complaint to Allah, that we need water for him and this is the blood of this baby. And then it was the time of Juma prayer and the people, they were shouting enemies that quickly kill Hussain because there is the time of prayer. So Hazrat Imam Hussain radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he took time and he was going to perform 2 rakah namaz prayer. And when he was in sajda, Shimmar Zil Joshan, he cut the head of Hazrat Imam Hussain radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And he took the head on his spear and he was dancing. That, oh people, see, I have killed the chief of chiefs. Give me diamond, give me money, this and this. It shows that they people were bribed. They were given task that you have to do this, then we will mean Yazid and his regime, they will promote you. Then they run the horses on the dead bodies of those people and they captured their families. Hazrat Zainab Razi Allah Ta'ala Anha, the sister of Hazrat Imam Hussain Razi Allah Ta'ala Anha. And one person survived, Hazrat Zainul Abidin Razi Allah Ta'ala Anha. He was the son of Imam Hussain Razi Allah Ta'ala Anha. Then these people, they were arrested, they were took to Kufa in front of Ubaidullah bin Ziyad. And Ubaidullah bin Ziyad, he was very happy because he was victorious at that time apparently. He stood up and he was having a stick. He beaten with that stick the teeth of Hazrat Imam Hussain radiallahu ta'ala anhu. The cut head was in front of him. Upon this, Hazrat Anas bin Malik radiallahu ta'ala anhu, a companion of Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he shouted. He said, oh Ubaidullah, I have seen Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam kissing these lips where you are beating. And then he said to Hazrat Zainab radiallahu ta'ala anhu, Ubaidullah bin Ziyad, that you have seen that we are on right path. Allah has given us victory and you people are wrong. Hazrat Zainab radiallahu ta'ala replied, no Mr. Ziyad, Allah knows that who is on right and you know that you are where. We have accepted the will of Allah. We have sacrificed. We are happy with Allah in this hardship. Then Hazrat Zainab and his family, with the cut head, they were sent from Kufa to Damascus in front of Yazid. Then after a few months, they sent to Medina. By this way, this tragedy came to an end. And what is the lesson here? That Imam Hussain radiallahu ta'ala anhu, against a tyrant ruler, he didn't compromise on his principles. And he sacrificed his life, his family life, each and everything he sacrificed for one cause. That was right is right. And this is the end of this tragedy. Then after, when they returned back to Medina, this family, the people of Medina, they were too much unhappy with Yazid. And after 1 year, they announced that we didn't accept Yazid as ruler. Next year, Yazid sent his army to attack Medina if the people, they show resistance. For 7 days, the horses, they remained near or in Masjid Nabawi, and for 7 days there was no Salah in Masjid Nabawi. And on the 3rd year, Yazid sent his army to Makkah, because in Makkah, Abdullah bin Zubair, son of Hazrat Asma, daughter of Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq, he was against Yazid. The people of Makkah, they accepted Abdullah bin Zubair as ruler. So Yazid sent his army over there, and they killed Abdullah bin Zubair and his companions over there. Meanwhile, Yazid died, mean in the 3rd year. And his son, Muawiyah, Yazid's father name was Muawiyah, and his son name was Muawiyah Thani, Muawiyah II. He became ruler. After 40 days or 6 months, he gathered his whole family and he told them that I have investigated the situation. I came to this result that my father was a cruel person. This chair of this caliphate, not caliphate, the ruler, this chair is based on the blood of Ahl al-Bayt, and I don't want to sit here. He left that chair and rest of his life without any fame he spent. And for your interest, who became ruler after Muawiyah Thani? Marwan bin al-Hakam, who wrote forged letter during Usman's time, and that letter became the major reason of assassination of Usman. Do you know about him? You have read in Usman's chapter that a forged letter was this. It was written by Marwan bin al-Hakam. This people, then after Yazid's son, he became the king of Muslims, and the Umayyad dynasty started from Hazrat Amir Muawiyah, but he is the next major person.